were that the family, this entire group, now he's not talking about the company, this entire group is being run by Mr. Ratan Tata. He's not on the board of Tata Sons, but he's having control in his hand. And other directors are nothing but the puppets of Mr. Ratan Tata. This is what has been, allegations have been leveled in the petition. But anyway, NCLT has passed ultimately verdict in favor of Mr. Ratan Tata. Now the matter has gone to NCLAT. So matter is sub judice. But I tell you, friends, dear students also, if you really want to understand how Indian corporate sector is functioning, is working, this is one of the best judgments I've ever read. 368-page judgment. What actually has transpired in the entire group, where from the business started in 18th century, from there till 2018, this verdict goes on. Each and every development which happened in this particular group is part of this judgment. So even though you want to understand what actually happened in Tata Group, please go through this judgment. This was passed last month. Now the matter is sub judice, no doubt NCLAT is seized of the issue, and I am very sure this matter ultimately will go to Supreme Court. And then Supreme Court will come out with its final verdict, what exactly is the meaning of the family business, how the family business are being run, whether Tata Group is being run as a family business or not. Ultimately, Supreme Court will come out with the verdict. We have to wait. But truth of the matter is same, as my friend Vikas also said. There has to be distinction between the family control and professional management. Unless this distinction is there, unless this family-owned businesses, the families take help of the professional management, the businesses can't flourish. One of the recent incidents I discussed with you, that SEBI has mandated appointment of one woman director on the boards of listed companies. What most of the listed companies did, they appointed one of their family women as member of the board. So this was a compliance in letter, not in spirit. Now taking a cue from this, now this quota committee recommended, let there be one woman independent director. Oh, now that has been implemented in April 2018. Now listed companies have to have one woman independent director on the board. But now the question arises, how many independent directors are actually independent in India? That is a very big question. Because in some of the cases, the independent directors are getting a remuneration of 3 to 4 crores per annum from the listed companies. Once you get this much of amount, can you remain independent? That's again a big question. Coming to this one more, I'm sorry, I'm taking a longer time. What happened in case of Reliance Industries, I still remember in 2002 when Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani expired. After that, the entire empire came to both his sons. In 2003, I remember in Vigyan Bhavan, the Corporate Governance Award function was there from Institute of Company Secretaries of India, and I was part of the award committee. At that point of time, Reliance Industries was given Best Corporate Governed Company of the country. Mr. Anil Ambani came there to receive this award. And within next 6 months, same Mr. Anil Ambani said, there is no corporate governance in Reliance Group. So this is how the family businesses are being run. Thank you.
Beautifully narrated by Mr. Madan, sir. We thought of building rather than just discussing on the textual thing, we thought of bringing some more case studies. So I request Sangeeta Madam to please narrate. I always consider, from when I was used to be there in the school or college, I always consider Infosys as a very professionally managed company. So why at that time, after some time, Narayan Murthy basically took a retirement from Infosys, then subsequently other founders also took retirement from Infosys. Why? What actually has happened? Why Narayan Murthy has to again step in as a chairman? The company was being managed by a professionally qualified person. He was a very professionally qualified person. They were having independent board. Why he has to step in again? Just to bring back the reputation of Infosys, just to control the losses of the company. What has happened? It has again come to one conclusion, or maybe some debatable question, is founder control a very much necessary directly or indirectly in India?
Dear students, why we are discussing here the case study like Infosys, like Reliance, like as sir said, Tata. The point we have to understand is we need all these businesses. The problem occurs due to improper succession planning. Who will be our next leader? Leader kaisa hona chahiye? What should be his role? And as well as what will be the role? Because transparency nahi thi un sare decision mein. Reliance mein jab Dhiru bhai sir nahi rahe, to there was expectation ki Anil Ambani will be under Mukesh Ambani sir. But later on what happened we know very well. The point is proper succession planning agar nahi hai kisi bhi business mein, chahe wo family owned business hai ya non family owned business hai. The important point is we should plan succession planning in considerable time. We generally, Indian business generally, even globally, succession planning ko discuss nahi kiya jata hai timely. The timely succession planning is not who will be the next leader. It is a process to develop the leader. What should be the roadmap to create leaders for their business? In Infosys also, we have seen this problem. Infosys was a family owned business. Jab tino jo uske founders the wo retire hue Shibu Lal ke baad mein, then they thought ki professional person should take care of this business to run Infosys smoothly. But jab sikka ne charge liya, sikka ne charge leke jab 4 saal mein hi what happened? Problem kahan create hui hai? Problem ye create hui ki jo founder the Narayan Murthy sir, founder ka control kaisa rehta hai after his retirement? That is the very important thing. Founder in terms of shareholder, founder in terms of board member, unki position kya hai, daily, day-to-day business ke decision mein unka involvement kitna hai, aur CEO ko power kitni hai, jo bhi incoming jo leader hai, usko kitna environment, board kitna support karta hai. Infosys mein, jab company downfall ho raha tha, to ye decision hua ki new ideas aane chahiye company ke andar, which was, Narayan Murthy was against of this. सिक्का ये चाहते थे कि हम किसी कंपनी को एक्वायर करें बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस रोबोटिक्स वाली चीज़ें डेवलप हो रही थी. तो इन्फोसिस में जो लीडर थे उनका ये एक्सपेक्टेशन था कि हम किसी नई कंपनी को एक्वायर करें. दैट डिसीजन वॉज रिजेक्टेड बाय द बोर्ड एंड बोर्ड में कंट्रोल किसका था? नारायण मूर्ति का. तो यहाँ बात आती है कि फाउंडर्स कंट्रोल कैसा होना चाहिए फॉर द न्यू कमिंग CEO. उसकी एक्सपेक्टेशन क्या है बिजनेस को ग्रो करने में? नए आइडियाज़ को, नए इनोवेशन को आप अगर इनवाइट नहीं करेंगे तो वहाँ पे बिजनेस में एक ऑब्स्टिकल आता है.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस, अभी मैम ने जो नरेट किया उससे एक सवाल इंस्टेंटली मेरे दिमाग में आया जो आई थॉट विल आस्क विकास सर टू प्लीज गाइड अस ऑन द सेट ऑन द सेम. एक सवाल, क्या प्रोफेशनली मैनेज लोग जब किसी भी फैमिली ओन बिजनेस बोलें या फिर कंपनी विच इज़ कंट्रोल्ड बाय प्रमोटर्स में जब प्रोफेशनली मैनेज लोग आते हैं तो डू एग्जिस्टिंग एम्प्लॉय हु लुक देमसेल्फ कि आई एम गोइंग टू स्टेप एज अ न्यू CEO और मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर, डू दे रेजिस्ट? इज द प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज ऑफ देयर रेजिस्टेंस कि दे लुक कि आई विल बी द नेक्स्ट CEO इफ समबडी एल्स हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड? सो इज देयर अ रेजिस्टेंस इन द मेन प्रॉब्लम और really the problem is the founders does not want to leave the control. They resign from the company, they resign from the board, they surrender the chair, but still they want the controlling powers into their hands. So I would like Vikas sir to please help us out or to guide us up on the debatable topic, although it's a very debatable topic. There may be, every coin has two toss, so it may be have one side of positive or negative. So I would like Mr. Vikas to please narrate on the same.
So as you said, it's a classic debate and which has been going on for not just a few decades but many decades, almost 100 years. And whether your next leader has to be in-house homegrown or he has to be brought in from outside, both have got their pluses and minuses. Brought in from outside for fresh blood, fresh ideas, fresh perspective, fresh expertise. In-house because of culturally developed, groomed person who understands the requirement of the businesses, who knows everyone, the environment is same. Also, he spent more time within the organization. So he understands the organization. So I don't think nobody has ever been able to find a correct answer to it as a yes or no. It'll always be dependent on the circumstances and the nature of business. Also, if we step back from succession. So succession is, you know, it's a classic case in India. They say one starts thinking of writing a will or thinking of succession when he gets his first heart attack. It's that late that we start. It's not something, succession is not something which you replace yourself with another in one stroke. It's a process where somebody, it's not like a relay race which you see in Olympics where one hands over the baton and the other one has to run. It is not as simple as that. This one has to get into it. And founders' control also will play a lot of role in how succession is planned. And which typically, of course, there is no right or wrong about it, will depend on the life cycle or the stage of the life cycle of the business. So if it's a startup, understandably, the founder will need absolute and complete control. He has to bring together all particles which are affecting his business into one cohesive unit. And that he can do when he understands each bit of the business. So if you go and ask the founder of Uber, he said, I myself drove taxis to understand what was the market like. Or if you go to one of the large print businesses, newspaper publishing, they started their careers as journalists. And that's when the business starts. But imagine when that turns into a successful enterprise, it's brought that business into one cohesive unit. And then it's